Hey Equippers kids, and welcome to week two of Worship Wednesday. We're so glad you're here to join us this week. And it's been an awesome week seeing you send in all your content, your IM sheets, you building your towers and knocking them over, your forts, and of course your TikToks. I mean, some awesome dance moves. So last week we looked at praise and we looked at four different D's, and they were design, distract, defy, and destroy. But what are we looking at this week, Michelle?
Well, this week we're moving on to our second foundation, and that is prayer.
Awesome.
Prayer is such a key to walking a faithful life with God.
Yeah.
And it's not like you might have seen it maybe as a child when you looked in picture books or movies. Maybe you saw a picture of a kid like this by their bed, or maybe in the movies they're holding hands to say grace. Mm. Those are great methods of prayer, but actually, prayer is a continuous conversation that we have with God. We talk to Him the good days, the bad days, and everything in between.
Yeah.
It's kind of like you have a hotline to heaven. Perhaps you have a cell phone, or mum or dad do, and they have somebody on speed dial. That means that if you press number one, it's going to call that person straight away.
Yeah.
So my speed dial would be Josh. Maybe yours might be your mum or dad. But we want to have a spiritual speed dial straight to Jesus. So in every decision we're facing or circumstance, even the little things in life, we're constantly praying and considering God in the decision making.
Great, yeah, and a great verse on that subject is Matthew 7 verse 21 to 23. It says, "Not everyone who calls out to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. Only those who actually do the will of the Father will enter in."
It's kind of a scary thought, isn't it? That even though we might call God, God, He might one day say to us that He didn't know us because we weren't doing His will.
Wow.
But how do we know if we're doing the will of the Father?
Well, it says in the Bible that we're to love God and to love people.
Well, that makes sense then, doesn't it? Jesus is meant to be like our best friend. And if you have a best friend, you would talk to them, right? Some of us say that we love Jesus, and yet prayer is not a daily part of our lives, but prayer is just talking with God.
Yeah.
It's like a no-caller ID. When you get a phone call and it comes up and it doesn't say who's calling you, you answer the phone and you might know who they are. You might be able to recognize straight off of their voice. Like, if Josh called me, I'm pretty confident, even if it said no caller ID, I would know it was Josh. Or my mum or my dad, I'd know their voice.
Yeah.
We want to be like that with Jesus. He wants to know our voice so clearly because we talk to Him all the time. It's not like once in a year He hears from Michelle. I want Him to hear from Michelle every single day, in the same way I want to hear from Him.
So good. Yeah, and our key verse today, it comes out of 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 16 to 18, and that says, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus."
That's a big word, without ceasing. But really, it's quite simple. All it means is, just like we said, you're never going to stop.
Yeah.
Without ceasing means that every second of every day, God is involved in your conversations, He's involved in your actions, He's involved in your dancing, your sport, your family conversations.
Absolutely.
Every single part of your life He wants to be integrated, and for you to be praying and involving Him in those spaces. So we're going to talk about just three keys today, three ways that you can really cement prayer as part of your everyday life.
Yeah, great. And the first one is thanksgiving. Now, thanksgiving is so important to be, it's something that we practice and outwork on a daily basis. Thanksgiving keeps our hearts soft towards God and towards people. And it actually makes people like us a whole lot more as well, I think so. But we see in Luke 7, the lady with the alabaster jar. Now, Jesus had forgiven her a few chapters earlier for her sin, and she was so thankful for what Jesus had done that she brought the most expensive perfume, broke it over His feet, and washed His feet with that. And they say it was worth a year's wages. Now, that's a thankful person. And it's like, how can we show our gratitude and our thanks toward God and even towards others? So a great activity this week would be maybe to make a card for your parents, or to do the dishes, or maybe even make dinner. It would be a great way to show thanks.
And we would love to see the way that you choose to give thanks this week. So maybe if you do one of those things for your parents or your siblings or someone you're in isolation with, how about you take a photo and tag us at Equippers Kids so we can see what you're up to.
Awesome.
There's also a spirit that we want to make sure we're praying with, and that is the spirit of faith. There's a really amazing story in the Bible about a group of friends who have faith to believe that their friend can be healed by Jesus. The church is packed, but they know that Jesus is in there. So rather than try and get their friend through the door or the windows, they climb up on the roof and lower him down. That takes a lot of faith. And how does Jesus respond? He heals the man instantly. We want to be the same with our prayer requests. We don't want to live a boring or predictable Christian life.
Yeah.
We want to be asking for the impossible things,
right.
The things that we could only do if God came behind us with the weight of heaven. Things like maybe the salvation of a friend or family member
yeah.
that you think would be impossible to see come to church. Maybe even the school bully or someone that you don't get along with. God still loves that person.
Right.
How could you go after them in prayer and in faith? Maybe it's a broken relationship that you want to see restored, or a miracle or a healing like in the story. We can pray for all of the big things, but we can also pray for the small things as well.
That's true, and so that takes us to our third point, which is request. Now for so many, if not for everyone, this is a very uncertain time and a lot of things are different and a lot of our needs have changed. But you know, we can bring those needs to God and we can bring a request to Him, to His feet, and you know, we talked about faith and how we can have faith for the big things, but we can also request God to show up in the little things.
Yeah.
Maybe that's in a friendship, maybe you need something this week like food, or you need a little bit of extra something, you can actually ask God for that. And there's a guy in the Bible called Abraham, and he did that on behalf of a nation. Now God was going to wipe out a nation, but he put a request and it was like, God, if there was 50 righteous people, would you save them? And gradually he made his way down there, and it's like, it doesn't matter how big or how small our request is to God, God is listening and God wants to hear your request.
It doesn't even have to be something that we want. It could just be a spirit we need, like God's
yeah.
spirit of peace.
Absolutely.
Or God's spirit of joy. Maybe you're feeling a little bit sad or a little bit lonely. We can pray about those things too. He cares about how we feel and He
yeah.
wants to meet with us in our prayers.
So good.
So we got a really awesome prophetic word from Pastor Helen that we want to share with you. And it was about this idea of prayer bubbles. So a bubble is something we blow into and it lifts and then it pops and then you see all of the film or whatever you would call that liquid stuff that's around the outside. Pops and drops down to the ground. And that's kind of like our prayers. In faith, we breathe prophecy. We breathe all of our faith into this bubble.
Yeah.
And then God lifts it towards His heart and then over the person we were praying for,
mm.
or the country or the nation or the situation we were praying for, our bubble pops and those things fall down and find their resting place. So we're
good.
Wanting to create this awesome new kind of tradition.
Very
we're calling it hashtag popping prayers, or hashtag
pop culture.
Because we want to make sure that prayer becomes a part of our everyday kingdom culture,
yeah.
the way we're living our lives.
So good.
What we want you to do this week is take a picture of you blowing bubbles, and then we want to know, what was it that you were believing for or praying for when you blew those bubbles? Maybe you were believing that God could be released over Europe or Asia or Africa or New Zealand. Maybe it was that you were believing that your mum or dad or an auntie, uncle might come to know Jesus.
Yeah.
But we want to know, what is the faith, what is the prophecy that you're sending into that bubble that God's lifting towards His heart and then popping over and releasing into every part of the world?
So
exciting,
good.
Right? Make sure you use our hashtags. Let's remind you of them. Hashtag popping prayers and
hashtag pop culture.
We hope that you love tuning in for our second week of transforming our foundations. When you talk too much, that's what happens, guys. But we'll see you next week. We hope you have a lot of fun. Josh is going to pray us out and then enjoy the next week's worth of awesome content that will be coming your way from Equipers Kids.
Awesome. God, we just pray for every child right now, God, wherever they are. And God, whatever situation they find themselves in, God, I pray that we would be a people of prayer. God, that we would be thankful. God, we would have a spirit of thanksgiving, that in everything you've done for us, our parents do for us, God, we thank you for it first. And God, I pray that you would, Lord, stir a faith inside each one of us. God, you would put a person on our heart, Lord, that we can pray for, that needs healing, that needs salvation. And God, we see that come to pass in Jesus' name. And God, even the request, God, we put towards you, God, if we're needing a change in spirit, just even some peace, God,
yeah.
just some freedom from anxiety. God, I just pray that you would release that into every child this week. And God, we just pray you would go before us. God, you cover us in Jesus' name. Amen.
So lots and lots of love from Josh and myself. We hope you have the best week and we'll see you next week for Worship Wednesday.
Awesome.
Bye, guys.
See ya.